Hello everyone, this is Sambit Suman from IHM Bhubaneswar. Today, I'll demonstrate some of the delicacies of Bengali cuisine. As you all know that, Bengal is full of joy and happiness and very rich in culture, heritage, festivals, food and many more. So it has a great influence and importance in Indian cuisine. Today, what we have in the menu is ghee bath, machar jol, aloo posto and misti doi. Ghee bath is a rice preparation which is very famous in Bengal. It is generally prepared in festive season as well as in special occasions. Whenever we used to prepare any kind of rice preparation, we generally follow two types of method, that is the draining method and the absorption method. Here we'll follow the absorption method, and the ratio of absorption method is 1:2. 1 is rice and 2 is water. The next dish is the main dish, that is the machar jol. People in Bengal are very fond of eating mach and bath. Machar jol is a traditional fish curry preparation which is very popular in eastern India, that is Odisha and Bengal. It is generally served with steamed rice. The local fish which are available in Bengal like pabda, rui, katla, mrigal are generally used to prepare this curry. The next dish is aloo posto. Aloo posto is a potato based dish which is blended with poppy seed paste and flavored with black cumin seed. It is said a Bengali thali is incomplete without aloo posto. The next dish is the dessert, which is very popular in Bengal, is misti doi. The name of misti doi says everything. Misti is sweet and doi is the curd. It is a yogurt based dessert which is very simple but very unique in taste. So let's start the menu first. To start a menu, we should start with the dessert first, because desserts are something which are served cold or at room temperature. Let's check the ingredients for misti doi. Take 1 liter of full fat milk in a saucepan. Keep flame to low or medium and boil the milk. Stir occasionally when the milk is getting heated. Simmer milk till it reduces to 1/3 or half of its original volume. Add the palm jaggery. When adding jaggery, the temperature of milk can be 60 to 65 degrees Celsius. Mix very well till all the jaggery is dissolved. Add 1/2 teaspoon cardamom powder. Mix well. Keep it aside to warm. Now add 2 tablespoons curd and mix well. Now pour the doi mixture in earthen or terracotta bowls. Cover with aluminium foil. Let's check the ingredients for ghee bath. Take basmati rice which was cleaned, washed and soaked for 30 minutes. Heat ghee in a degchi. Add the whole spices. add soaked rice. And stir for 5 minutes. Add hot water, double the amount of rice along with salt. Cover the dekchi with a lid. Cook until 90% done. Add sugar and adjust the seasoning. Saute knots with ghee in frying pan. Garnish with grated khoya and nuts. Serve hot. Let's check the ingredients for matcha jhol. The fish was nicely cleaned and pat dried. After that, marinate the fish with salt and turmeric for 15 minutes. Shallow fry and keep it aside. Heat mustard oil in a kadai. Temper kala jeera and slitted green chilies and ginger paste. Saute for a few minutes. Add chopped tomatoes, salt, and cook for some time. Add turmeric powder, red chili powder, cumin powder and mix well. Once masala is cooked, add hot water to make thin gravy. Add the fried fish to the gravy, simmer it for some time. Check for seasoning and garnish with chopped coriander leaves. Serve hot. Let's check the ingredients for aloo posto. Heat mustard oil in a pan, add onion seeds, add the potatoes, fry for about 5 minutes. The potatoes should not be brown, so keep stirring them regularly. The poppy seed was soaked and pasted. Cut the potatoes in 1 cm cubes. Add the poppy seed paste along with salt and sugar. Cook on low heat until the raw smell of poppy seed goes away. Continue cooking on low heat with lid on until the potatoes are soft. Once in a while, when the pan dries out, you may have to add a splash of hot water to ensure the potatoes don't stick to the pan. Finish with green chilies and heated mustard oil.